I'm Tom Caputi. This is going to be a really fast talk, basically just on a new prefetcher that I've been working on as part of work on sequential scrubs, which I think Sasha is going to talk a little bit about in a bit, but he also talked about it extensively last year. But basically, this is just a tiny little addition to it that I think could have more applications in other parts of the code. To give some really quick background on how Scrubs works, for those of you who aren't familiar with that code, this is all you really need to know for the purposes of this talk. Scrubs and Resilver use exactly the same code. It just basically, there's like a couple of if statements that are like one-liners that determine whether or not you're doing Resilver or a Scrub. But essentially, they're using the same code. Scrubs happen completely in syncing context, so we know that the pool state isn't going to be trying to change out from under us. And basically, we just run for a certain amount of time in syncing context. Once we've used up all of our time, then we stop scrubbing, wait, let the transaction sync through, and then we pick up next transaction and we reconcile any state that might have changed. That might have changed, you know, when the transaction went through. This is kind of like an iterative process, and there's a good amount of code there to just reconcile the state and make sure that like we're not scrubbing something that we just freed. When I say scrubbing, by the way, I'm always talking about scrubbing or resilvering, but just for ease of saying it, I'm just going to say scrubbing. Now, the way that scrubs actually work is basically it's pretty simple. It just goes through everything in the MOS, and it will iterate through all of the object sets in the MOS once it's done with the MOS, and then it will traverse through all of the blocks of all of the object sets in there. And that's pretty much all it does. It has a little bit of intelligence in terms of like it understands that if this is a snapshot of a data set that it scanned before, then it, you know, will use the birth time of that the birth transaction group of that snapshot to make sure that it's not redoing work that it's already done. But really, it's just iterating through every object set that it finds. And basically, the way that scrubs work, and this is kind of just the last bit of information so that you understand how scrubs work. It's not really relevant to this talk, but basically, scrubs just completely utilize the self-healing code that ZFS, you know, is very well known for and, you know, very well established. But basically, it just reads every copy of every block or all of the parity blocks, and it just makes sure that all of it matches and the checksums are correct and goes from there. So this is how, this is a talk about prefetching as we're scanning through this. So how can we make this scanning through, so imagine this is just a single object set, and we're just talking about making scanning through a single object set faster. Currently, this is kind of what it works with. Everything that's gray is stuff we haven't read yet. Everything that's green, which will happen in a second, is stuff that we have prefetched, and everything that's red is stuff that we've actually scanned and scrubbed or resilvered. So basically, the first thing that we do is we read the top level block, and then we immediately prefetch all of the blocks underneath that. After that, it's a depth first search. Goes down, prefetches the blocks below that, scans each one of these, does the scrub, comes up here, same thing. So this is how it currently works. But this has a few problems, and I'll refer back to that diagram in a second. Basically, prefetches are held up by a synchronous arc read. So for instance, if you look right here, when we went from this to this, this was doing a synchronous arc read to get the next layer down. And we didn't issue any prefetches until that arc read actually completed. So, as a result, basically, while we're waiting for these arc reads to happen, the disks are pretty much quiet except for that one I/O that is outstanding because scrubs are completely single-threaded like this. So that's one problem. Next problem is that the first prefetch below a given block is effectively kind of useless. We're going to pretend that this is like a completely ideal case where you run a prefetch and it starts an I/O and then it immediately returns, and we're going to pretend that takes zero time. It effectively does when you compare it to disk time.
But, so when this happens, so we scan this and we immediately start prefetching the blocks below it. And then we read this block. That prefetch is
effectively useless because we immediately go and read all of the copies of that block anyway. So
this prefetch is kind of, this first one is kind of lost. Everything after that, we get some performance gains on, just in terms of, you know, we've read this data before, but in this case, we didn't even just because it's leaf blocks,
and so we had to read all of the copies of this anyway. So that's not great. We're basically doing some, we're issuing prefetches, but they're not helping us as much as they could be. Finally, this results in burst EIO requests, and as any sys engineer will probably tell you, they really like to see consistency. They like to see good, consistent performance.
But again, going back to, and this is just an easy way to show it, but here, so now when we went from this state to this state,
we issued one read and three prefetches. So this was doing four IOs at once.
But
for each one of these, we're only doing the single scrub IO at a time because scrubs are completely single threaded. This has some work that I'm working on in terms of sequential scrubs, which, again, Sasha did a very nice talk about last year and all the performance gains there. Not the subject of this talk, but basically, while we're doing these scrubs, nothing else is kind of happening. So the performance is very bursty. We either hit an indirect block where we can prefetch everything under it, and we immediately issue all those prefetches, or we're doing a regular scrub, and you know we're just doing one block at a time. So this is the ideal thing. That's the problems with the one. Ideally, we would like to be able to do something a lot closer to this,
where we, I'm sorry, the top one should be red, but we scan the top block, we immediately prefetch everything under that,
and then we immediately prefetch everything under that. But we shouldn't have to wait for scanning anything, because that should be a separate process. You know, the prefetching should be able to be separate and not held up by these synchronous scrub operations that are kind of happening like that.
We would like to be able to
not have to wait for anything except for the blocks that we needed to discover, the lower level blocks. We'd like to just immediately start scrubbing as soon as we are capable of, we'd like to immediately prefetch lower level blocks instead of waiting for these other operations. So that is, but that is a little too idealistic and it has some real limitations. The problem with this is that it makes two really bad assumptions. First, it says that the object set will completely fit in memory, because in this, we prefetched the whole thing, put it in memory before the scrub got a chance to do anything. And the other thing is that the I.O. can all be issued in parallel. So if we just tried to prefetch, for instance, let's say we got to the lower level here, and we have two disks, and you know they're, again, I'm simplifying this so that it all fits on the screen, but let's say that we can only actually do like two I.O.s at once. And we try to issue all nine of these bottom layer ones. That might not be great, and you know the prefetcher might issue these all, or might get these all back in kind of a random order, which isn't great because
we're going to use the ones going down the left side first.
So what's the solution to this? The solution is just to prefetch is to change the prefetch function so that it just places IOs inside of a priority queue. We want to prioritize the IOs that we're going to want to use first. So in this case, we want the ones going down the left-hand side first. Once we prioritize these, we're going to prioritize these based on their bookmark. This code actually already exists and is used for a different thing in the scrubbing code, but basically the idea is we can use the bookmark to figure out along with the block sizes and indirect block shifts and things like that, to figure out which bookmarks go before which ones in this whole tree. Once we do that, so now we have this priority queue, and then we can just spin up a thread that will actually issue all the prefetches, and once it has issued all these prefetches, that thread can also manage all the rate limiting and all of that kind of stuff to make sure that the performance isn't bursty. So what does this look like? So basically the idea here is imagine that we have a disk that we are arbitrarily saying here that this pool can handle two IOs at once. And I'm going to show everything is queued in gray, everything that is already prefetched in green, and everything that we haven't touched yet in white as I did before. So first we're going to queue up the top level block, and we're just put that in the queue. At that point, the prefetch thread is going to use that because it's the only thing in the queue, it's the first thing in the queue, and it's going to proceed and issue it. As soon as that comes back, we discover all these new blocks, and we use that callback of reading those blocks to find all these other ones and put them in the queue. So now we have all of these in the queue, 1, 2, and 3. Now, we prioritized 1, 2, and 3 so that we want to issue them in that order. But at this, like I said before, we're assuming that we can issue two IOs at a time. So we issue those two at a time because those are the two highest priority ones that we have. Now, when we get those callbacks back, we have a queue that looks like this. And we continue. So basically, you know, following the bottom left, we can then prefetch those. Basically, the ARC code was adjusted so that prefetch IOs can have a read callback. Right now, there's a limitation where they can't, and there's some really weird stuff that happens if you try, but that's been fixed. And ARC read done was adjusted so that the read callback that you get back can give you just a little bit of information about what you were reading. So basically, the block pointer and the Xio bookmark. This could actually be really helpful in some other parts of the code, which I'll get to in a second. There are currently three prefetching implementations that ZFS has, which I kind of find surprising, and that's not including the predictive prefetch, which is, you know, kind of its own thing. Debug.c is the one that probably gets used the most. That is, you know, the just generic prefetcher for using the file system and object sets and default and all these things. But that has its own mechanisms, which completely work based on, they attempt to work based on these callbacks, but the interesting thing about them is that they just drill down to get to a single lower level block. I think the ARC read done is where, like I talked about, where we give the block pointer and the Xio bookmark to the ARC read done callback. I think that'll matter a good bit here, and all of that comes for free because the ARC layer already had all this information. In DMU traverse, we have prefetching, and that's mostly used for things like sends. And to me, this seems like almost the exact same problem as DSL scan. It needs to do the exact same things. It's just slightly different, you know, limitations of what can possibly be going on. But I think that this new prefetcher could have good, a good impact if we applied it there and we tried to make a more generic prefetcher that works across both of these. That's pretty much it. Anybody have any questions?
The prefetching that you're doing for scan is still being done in CD context, correct?
Yeah, the question was these prefetches are done in CD context, and yes, that is true.
Have you IOs? In your example, you said you could do two IOs concurrently at a time.
Yeah, and that's a tunable, but basically, and this is just an example here.
Sure.
For in the actual. It's a tunable value, but
okay.
it's also per top level VDIF. So,
but you kind of, the administrator needs to know the hardware to set that.
Not really, because it's per top level VDIF, I guess they can tune up and down as they see fit. But I think the defaults will. It uses the same tunable which is currently in use, which is